Prior to my chief of staff role, I worked on our hypersonic air-breathing weapon concept program. It was the latest and greatest technology that can fly faster than 5 times the speed of sound. My name is Dr. Sally Morning. I'm the chief of staff for Raytheon's Advanced Technology Business Unit. We are developing cutting-edge technologies and capabilities that provide the solutions for our warfighters and our customers' greatest challenges and needs in order to bring our warfighters home. Hypersonics doesn't only mean offensive. That is certainly where our mind might default to, thinking about our programs such as HACM. But hypersonic development on the defensive side is also important. We have Raytheon products such as Standard Missile 3 and Standard Missile 6, and those are going to be the products that we use to defend against incoming hypersonic threats. The concept of hypersonic flight certainly isn't new, but to package everything into a vehicle to travel at 5 times the speed of sound, that's the problem. Your components need to survive the shock and vibe of launch, acceleration, sustained cruise at that Mach 5 or greater. You're pushing a lot of air out of the way, and that causes a lot of friction. So material selection is very important, and then that will go hand in hand with, can you manufacture a vehicle out of these exquisite materials? Maybe you suffer in speed to use a different material, but it still comes down to that heating problem and packaging those components to survive the environment of being hurtled through the atmosphere at 5 times the speed of sound. Because advanced technology does not focus on one certain customer or subset of customers, that allows us to have a very collaborative network of working with various labs and government agencies. And what that allows us to do, being so collaboration heavy, is we get to be the idea incubator of Raytheon. In advanced technology, we have a wide array of capabilities that we're developing, whether it be hypersonics, high-power microwaves, torpedoes, ranging from ship-based, ground-based, airborne sensors, photonics, infrared. The laundry list goes on. Advanced technology touches everything from seabed to space and everything in between. We're also the business unit that propelled some of our legacy systems into what they are today, such as Spy 6, LTAMDS, Next Generation Jammer, and our well-known HACM system, our hypersonic attack cruise missile. As a collegiate athlete, sports really taught me how to understand my role of being on a team. As a starter, I was expected to be a calm, cool, collected, and consistent player. If the ball's coming my way, I need to be able to pass, set, hit, block. I need to be able to do all those things. So over my 4 years, the dynamics of having those roles kind of reminds me of advanced technology in a lot of ways. Your teammates need to know what you need to be successful, but then you also need to understand your role on the program. For me personally, the work that we do at RTX is a mission unlike any other. It's to bring our warfighters home, make sure they have the unfair advantage. Again, it gets back to that competitive nature. I still take great pride and joy in knowing that our products are held to such a high standard that they need to work as advertised the first time, every time, no questions asked.